Tenemos el placer de contar precisamente con el científico de Harvard que, bueno, sigue desatando controversias con sus teorías. Hi, AB, thanks for being here with us in Negocios TV. It's a pleasure having you here. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
AB, we are talking again about Three Eyed Atlas. We are talking about the NASA, the theories that is a comet. What is your last reports about Three Eyed Atlas?
Well, I had two interesting insights over the past few days. One is that there was a report back in August that the 3A Atlas is rotating every 16 hours. And at the same time, the image we obtained from the Hubble Space Telescope indicated that most of the light is not coming from the nucleus, it's coming from the plume of gas and dust around this object. And I realized that, in fact, perhaps the variability that is periodic every 16 hours originates from the jets coming out of the object, that it's just like a heartbeat where every 16 hours there is a puff of gas and dust through the jets. And one possible origin for that, if it's a natural object, would be a pocket of ice, a large pocket of ice on one hemisphere. Whenever it turns in the direction of the sun, it gets warmed up by sunlight and then erupts in a outflow of gas and dust. The other possibility is, of course, a technological origin where there is some cycle within the system of 16 hours that releases jets, either for navigation purposes or just as output. So that's one interesting insight, and it's not related to the shape of the object as was suggested by the people who detected this variability every 16 hours. It's most likely related to the jets that are pulsed like a heartbeat coming from the object. The second realization that I had was actually very recent. Yesterday, I realized that in all the images after 3A Atlas came close to the sun, we seem to see a teardrop shape for the plume of glow around this object. And I realized that if, in fact, there were many small objects accompanying the big object, then in fact you would get naturally this teardrop shape based on gravity alone. The object was detected to have non-gravitational acceleration, meaning that there is a push of the object away from the sun. And if you have smaller objects surrounding it that are not being pushed by the same force, they will be lagging behind. They would be closer to the sun relative to the object. And I did the calculation for the non-gravitational acceleration that was reported for 3A Atlas, for the nucleus of 3A Atlas. Turns out that that's exactly the right amount to create this teardrop shape, where there is an elongation by of all the 50,000 kilometers in the direction of the sun. And that could be just the result of the object being pushed more than the smaller objects around it. And so the question then arises as to what's the nature of this swarm of smaller objects around the big object. And we don't know that, of course, but it's an interesting possibility. I submitted a paper about it this morning for publication.
Well, in for more reports, we are talking a lot about the anomalies of this 3A Atlas. We were talking about the level 4 of alert. What are these anomalies and why do you have this level of alert for the 3A Atlas?
Right, so I listed the 13 anomalies, unusual facts about 3A Atlas that need to be explained. You know, the most unusual one is the mass of the object being a million times more than the first interstellar object, if the object is indeed 5 kilometers to 10 kilometers in size. We don't know that for sure, but this is the current estimate. However, if we end up finding that the 3A Atlas is much smaller, less than a kilometer, then this unusual mass would go away. The other one is, of course, that it travels in the plane of the planets around the sun. And that's quite remarkable that a chance of one in 500 for it to be within 5 degrees of the ecliptic plane. And not only that, but it will arrive to Jupiter on March 16th, 2026, exactly at the distance where Jupiter's gravity dominates over the sun's gravity. And this distance is extremely precise, within 4 significant digits. It's exactly the so-called Hill radius, the distance from Jupiter where its gravity dominates. That could be a technological signature that implies that it wants to release some devices, for example, in the Lagrange points, which are situated at that distance from Jupiter. We put the Webb telescope at the Lagrange point number 2 next to the Earth, exactly where the Earth's gravity is canceled by the sun's gravity. So that remains to be seen if it will pass exactly at the Hill radius from Jupiter on March 16th. And then, you know, these various other properties of it are unusual. There are lots of jets coming out of it in directions that are not necessarily aligned with the sun. And we don't know the origin of these jets. Perhaps they are triggering the non-gravitational acceleration that we detected, which is needed to get this fine-tuned distance from Jupiter if there is a purpose for its visit. And then there are all kinds of other anomalies associated with nick composition anomalies, like nickel with very little iron that we find in industrial production of nickel alloys, or the fact that it has only 4% by mass water vapor in its in the plume of gas around it, quite unusual for a comet that we are familiar with from the solar system that is usually water rich. And then there are other coincidences that it arrives so close to three planets like Mars, Venus and Jupiter, and then it came just on the opposite side of the sun relative to Earth, as if it was trying to avoid us. And finally, there is a coincidence with the WOW signal, the radio signal. It arrived from within 9 degrees of the direction of the WOW signal from 1977. This is the only radio signal that we believe was definitely out there in the sky, but we don't know the source of it. And perhaps it was the senders of Three Atlas or Three Atlas itself. So there are all kinds of anomalies to do with its properties. And I listed 13 of them. And if it ends up being a natural object, we will need to explain all of them.
There is a lot of things to explain about this Three Atlas. AB, in this context, there is a growing rumor that Trump is going to announce the existence of extraterrestrial life. It's a rumor that we see a lot in the social media. Could it have something to do with Three Atlas?
Well, I do not know any fact related to these rumors, and perhaps they are wishful thinking on behalf of those who spread these rumors. I should say that there is a lot of misinformation on social media and also on YouTube. For example, there was a new channel on YouTube that was created with AI that features videos on my name. And this is not me speaking. It's actually AI generated videos. And so I suggest always checking primary sources whenever you hear get any information from social media, because it's not reliable most of the time. People just use it to either get clickbait or make money out of false information. In my case in particular, you can find all the updates on medium.com. I have a place where I put all my essays, aviloeb@medium.com. These are the genuine reports that I write. I don't have a YouTube channel. It's all fake AI.
A lot of misinformation about Three Atlas. One of these news talk about the UN, the United Nations. They were talking about the planetary defense exercise. Is this true, AB? The UN is putting the focus in this three eyed atlas, is observing, is watching the three eyed atlas?
I actually reached out to the United Nations about three eyed atlas, and I said that we need to collect as much data as possible. And then an organization related to the United Nations called the International Asteroid Warning Network decided to have a campaign of collecting as much data as possible about three-eyed atlas using hundreds of observatories around the globe. And they started the campaign on November 27th, just last week, and it will continue for 2 months. And I very much look forward to the data that will be collected. In general, there is a planetary defense office at NASA, and that was intended to protect the Earth against the rocks, because we know that the dinosaurs were killed 66 million years ago by a giant rock the size of Manhattan Island, an asteroid. And we want to prevent such a calamity from happening to us. And so the US Congress tasked NASA to identify 90% or more of all asteroids that are bigger than a football field, 140 meters. And that's why, for example, the Pan-STARRS Observatory and as well as the Rubin Observatory in Chile were constructed to survey the sky for near-Earth asteroids. So planetary defense had the meaning of protecting us against rocks in the past. And the new meaning that I'm trying to bring to this concept is that we need to be protected also potentially against alien technology. That's much more difficult because for a rock, you can forecast the path that it will take based on the laws of gravity and the law of motion. In the case of a technological object, it may maneuver in ways that we cannot anticipate. It may have an intent, and therefore it's much more challenging to cope with that, especially if we are dealing with technologies that are much more advanced than ours.
In this context, AB, waiting for more info about this exercise by the UN, is three-eyed atlas a threat for the humanity? We are waiting for the 19th of December. Is a threat the three-eyed atlas?
At this time, there is no indication that it poses any threat. Of course, what we can monitor is only the object itself. We don't know if it released small objects, because the objects that are less than 100 meters cannot be seen from a distance. They don't reflect enough sunlight within the Earth-Sun separation. But we could potentially see them if they arrive at Earth or near Mars. But the object itself seems to follow very closely the path that it originally had, and it was forecasted to follow. And that does not come very close to Earth. It will only come within 270 million kilometers from Earth on December 19th. So at the moment, there is no reason for us to worry about it. But what I would recommend is, aside from monitoring three-eyed atlas, checking if there is any unusual objects arriving at Earth or near Mars in the coming months.
Waiting for the 19th of December, waiting for more info, more reports about three-eyed atlas. AB, it's a pleasure having you here again. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me, and I will be delighted to discuss any future developments as well.
Thank you. Thank you, AB. Bueno, pues nosotros que vamos a seguir pendientes de las últimas horas en torno al 3-eyed atlas, estos informes que a menudo publica el científico de Harvard, AB Loeb. Vamos a hacer una pausa y enseguida miramos a la geopolítica con el presidente ruso Vladimir Putin, que está hablando en estos momentos, poniendo el foco en Pokrovsk. Dice que, bueno, que esta conquista, esta toma es de especial importancia para Rusia. Advierte que está bajo el control total del ejército ruso. Enseguida hablamos sobre la conquista de Pokrovsk. Vamos a mirar también al ultimátum de Trump a Maduro. Una pausa y enseguida todo es geopolítica. Negocios Televisión.